Hi and welcome to the channel. In this video, I'd like to provide a quick recap of what's happening with Android PC emulation on our devices. Things are getting wild out there. Please notice that besides this are exciting news, all this developments are on early stages and you should only try this for testing purposes in case you are an advanced user with a powerful smartphone. Otherwise you will be frustrated. Also, let's not forget that Qualcomm is now launching ARM chipsets for Windows, and it seems that Microsoft is supporting this with Prism, a powerful x86 emulation layer for ARM. So, the future looks bright for further improvements in this technology. Years ago, this was literally impossible, like a dream. But now, if you have a powerful Android device and a bit of effort and patience, you can play Windows PC games locally on your device without needing any cloud service software. This is possible thanks to some open source tools that we'll discuss later. The technology behind these tools nowadays essentially involves two components. 1. Wine, a compatibility layer that allows us to execute Windows apps on Android. 2. Box64, a binary translator for ARM64 systems, which Android uses, that allows executing apps and games on Android devices by emulating x86 and x64 instructions. Together, Wine and Box64 work to run a Windows game on an Android device. Wine handles the UI and Windows system calls, while Box64 translates the x86 code instructions to ARM64. Now that we understand how the tech works, let's look at the tools available. The ones I recommend have been tested by the community and, if downloaded from official sources, are safe from viruses. These tools are Winlator and Mobox. First up, let's talk about Winlator. It's a powerful app that lets you run Windows applications on your Android device, based on the Wine project. To get started, download the app from their official site, install the APK file, and set up a Windows environment by downloading the necessary files through the app. Next, we have Mobox, another great option for emulating Windows on Android, designed to optimize performance specifically for gaming. It's planned that a new Mobox Edge version will be launched in 2024 with several improvements. We'll check out that version once it's available. Comparing the two, Winlator is great for general Windows applications and lightweight games, especially because it includes a built-in controller and an RTS keyboard templated that can be customized. While Mobox is geared towards gamers needing extra performance for more demanding titles, offering smoother performance for higher-end games, but you need to install Input Bridge to have some in screen controller. In my next video about this topic, I will be testing both tools with some DRM-free video games. Apologies for not doing it, but in this channel, I want to bring you updates and useful tech tips that work for everyone, and so far this is too experimental. For now, I recommend checking out fellow YouTubers like Serg Pavlov, who has posted a lot of content about game configurations and performance and created a list of games he personally tested. This is an amazing job, and he did it for quite a while. Unfortunately, he decided to stop, so if we want more content from him, I encourage to subscribe to his channel and see if he can continue to illustrate us. As these projects evolve, it sometimes takes time for the community to adapt them to new Android versions or new CPUs and GPUs. Since Google won't proactively support this, we need to be patient if our new device doesn't work immediately, especially if your device uses a MediaTek chipset. It's incredible to see these developments. While it's currently experimental and not convenient for regular users due to legal implications and storage requirements, a AAA game might occupy more than 100 gigabytes. The potential is exciting. If you found this video helpful, hit that like button and subscribe for more gaming tips and tricks. Let me know in the comments which games you're excited to play on your Android device. Until next time, happy gaming.